Welcome to the AMD Vitis Design Implementation GitHub Quick Take video. In this video, we'll quickly introduce GitHub, overview the AMD Vitis DSPLib and its parts, direct you to Vitis tutorials on GitHub, explain Polyphase Channelizers, and demonstrate a design running in Ubuntu. Let's get started. Let's begin by understanding GitHub. This important website, powered by Git, helps manage project changes and teamwork. Key things to know are repositories, project folders, forks, personal copies, cloning, getting a local copy, branches, working separately, commits, save changes, and pull requests, merging work. Now that we understand the basics of GitHub, let's explore how to obtain the AMD Vitis DSPLib code. You have a few options. Cloning the repository, which is best if you plan to contribute or want to easily receive updates. Downloading the code as a zip file, a simpler approach for basic usage, or using GitHub Desktop, which provides a visual interface for cloning. Now let's discuss about the AMD Vitis Digital Signal Processing Library DSPLib, which is available in GitHub. This library offers a comprehensive suite of L1 and L2 elements for digital signal processing DSP. It includes two main components, the PLDSP library and the AMD Versal AI Engine DSP library. The PLDSP library is optimized for AMD FPGAs and adaptive SoCs and is organized into L1 PL primitives and L2 PL kernels. The Versal AI Engine DSP library includes L1 AI Engine kernels, L2 AI Engine graphs, and Vitis subsystem make files. The recommended starting point for using the library is the L2 AIE graph. Expanding on the AI Engine DSP library, this is an open source collection of DSP algorithms optimized for AMD Versal devices with AI engines. It features a configurable library of C++ kernels, utilizing intrinsics to leverage AI engine vector processing capabilities. These kernels can be combined to form graphs for complex designs, with each kernel having a corresponding graph. An example design is included for reference, and it's recommended to use the library element's graph as the entry point for development. Now, let's see some of the DSP library functions that supports both AIE and AIEML devices. And also, if you want to target a particular function, go to the user guide link provided. Now, shifting our focus to resources for learning, AMD Vitis Unified Software Platform is a complete development environment designed for creating applications that leverage FPGA fabric, ARM processor subsystems, and Versal AI engines. To get started, begin with the Getting Started tutorials, which introduce you to the basics of the Vitis platform and guide you through initial setup and simple projects. The tutorials are organized into several categories: AI engine development, hardware acceleration, developer contributed, embedded software, and platform creation. To access the tutorials, visit the Vitis Tutorials repository on GitHub, where you can clone the repository to your local system or download the contents as a zip file. Within the Vitis Tutorials repository on GitHub, the AI engine development tutorials are further organized into two main areas, AIEML and AIE. The AIEML category is optimized for machine learning development and can also be utilized for DSP digital signal processing designs. The AIE category focuses on developing advanced algorithms using the Versal AI Engine Array, which works in conjunction with PLIP or kernels and software applications running on embedded processors. The AMD Vitis tutorials are structured into categories, with each category further divided into feature tutorials and design tutorials. Feature tutorials focus on specific or advanced features that may not be required for all designs but are useful for special use cases. Design tutorials, on the other hand, illustrate higher-level concepts or design flows, providing walkthroughs of specific examples or reference designs. The AI engine development design tutorials highlight the two major phases of AI engine application development: architecting the application and developing the kernels. One such tutorial demonstrates a system-level design, example, Polyphase Channelizer, using both AI Engine and PL or HLS kernels. We are going to showcase how to use GitHub designs, using an example of a Polyphase Channelizer reference design. Before we do that, let's review some basics of Polyphase Channelizers. A Polyphase Channelizer uses advanced DSP techniques to downconvert several frequency division multiplex signals in parallel to baseband. Looking at the Polyphase Channelizer in more detail, we'll explore two cases, a simple case and an advanced case. The simple case consists of a polyphase filter, sometimes referred to as a filter bank, and an IFFT transform. Here, we show M channels. The channelizer divides the spectrum into M contiguous regions, downconverting them to baseband with a sampling rate that is M times smaller than the input rate FS. The advanced case works similarly, but additionally introduces a P by Q fractional oversampling of its outputs, using some additional DSP tricks afforded by the circular buffering and cyclic shift. To illustrate a practical example, consider a polyphase channelizer designed with an input sampling rate of 10.5 gigasamples per second and the capacity to handle 16 distinct channels, each with 656.25 megahertz bandwidth. It uses a polyphase technique to achieve an oversampled output at 750 megasamples per second, 8 by 7 times the channel bandwidth. The prototype filter has 8 taps per phase, resulting in a total of 128 taps for the system. The polyphase channelizer's functionality is achieved through 5 key processing blocks. 1. Circular buffer converts scalar input data to M vector format, managing P by Q oversampling with a memory depth of M times K samples. 2. Polyphase filter implements M parallel filters using K equals 8 coefficients from the channelizer prototype filter, producing M output samples. 3. Cyclic shift buffer removes frequency-dependent phase shifts from IDFT outputs using a periodically time-varying circular shift managed by a finite state machine. 4. Inverse fast Fourier transform, IFFT, performs IDFT on M samples, down-converting frequencies to produce separate channels of bandwidth FS by M sampled at a rate of FS by M into P by Q samples per second. 5. Output buffer prepares output channel samples for downstream processing, not included in the reference design. Let's move on to a practical demonstration of how to download and set up the Xilinx library from GitHub to get started with your development. First, click on the link provided in the video description. This will take you to the Xilinx/Vitis-Tutorials page on GitHub. Now log in into your GitHub account. Create an account if you don't have one. On the Xilinx/Vitis-Tutorials page, click on the Code drop-down box and select Download Zip to download the zip file containing all the necessary designs for development. Next, copy the downloaded zip file to your Ubuntu system and place it in the required directory. Open a terminal in Ubuntu, navigate to the directory where you placed the zip file, and enter the following command to extract the library. Then, go to the Polyphase Channelizer design, as shown here. Here, you will find all the required folders and files. Open the makefile in the Polyphase Channelizer directory and make the changes based on your tool installation path. Configure the environment variables and set the path where you have downloaded the common images, as shown in the video. These paths can also be updated in a single instance by creating an environment variable for the platform repo path and common images as shown in the callout. Similarly, update the makefiles present in the AIE folder. Ensure that you are in the design directory using the following command as shown here, and run the command make all target HRWMU to build the polyphase channelizer design for hardware emulation. This process will take about 90 minutes and generate a folder named Package, containing all necessary files for hardware emulation. Finally, navigate to the package directory using the following command and execute the launch hwemu.sh file as shown here to run the emulation. Optionally, add the -g flag to the launch hwmu.sh command to launch the AMD Vivado Waveform GUI for observing the top-level AXI signal ports in the design. That's it. You've successfully downloaded and set up the Xilinx library for your development.